It ain't a movement if it ain't moving. You ain't got no motion. The fuck?
Rule number one, keep faith in God. You know the devil gon' keep shooting. We shoot shots and we shoot movie. It ain't a movement if it ain't moving. Them boys strapped up like the Navy, so make sure you wanna do this. And before you do something stupid, know your life you finna ruin.
Hey, how y'all doing? How y'all
what's
doing?
Up?
This podcast, it ain't a movement if it ain't moving. Episode 2. I'm here with that boy JB. Charlie got them putting in work, you know what I'm saying? He a hot rapper, you know what I'm saying? I've been doing it for a while, you know what I'm saying? I want to bring him on here and chop it up with him for a little while, for a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Let y'all get to know him and see what's going on. Crazy flow, you know what I'm saying? Been putting in work for a long time, you know what I'm saying? Did I leave anything out?
Man, been going crazy, man, you know what I'm saying? Straight out of Atlanta, JB, Julio Band, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
well,
give me
the
IG and shit before
yeah,
we start.
My IG 1, Julio, JULIO, _ bands, BANDZ. You'll see me on that.
Y'all make sure y'all like and subscribe.
All that shit. I'm on YouTube, videos on YouTube, Apple Music, Spotify. Anywhere you see music at, I'm on it. Look me up, follow with me. We in that WMG. So different. We out there. Julio Bands, what's up?
If you ain't got no motion, the fuck?
Going on.
We're gonna start off with, you know, we just get started, so I got my questions here, man. Y'all don't have to unfold with me, man. Don't be killing me in the comments and shit.
Man,
you know what I'm saying?
Get it, man.
We're gonna start off with, what first got you into music?
What first got me into music? I think I was in like the ninth grade. I always loved music, you know what I'm saying, growing up, like I always loved music, like my daddy used to listen to music all the time when I was growing up, my mom, he used to always play music, so I always loved music, but I feel like that 50 Cent album, like I used to always love music, but that 50 Cent, the first album, Get Rich or Die Trying?
I think 50 did an interview, and he said, like how we was about pop.
Yeah.
You know, like the younger generation coming, they say, I'm their pop. You know what I'm saying?
For real.
And what you saying that's the first thing I thought about.
Yeah. Because see, it's like, see, coming up, I caught like the tail end of pop, but I was like a young nigga.
Like you caught that Machiavelli.
Yeah, you feel me? Like I caught that Machiavelli, so you know, I'm like, alright. Okay, I see what's going on, but it was like, 50 Cent was like, they Get Rich or Die Trying, it was like, all right, that set the tone for this shit. It was like, all right, you know what I'm saying? And that was like, I feel like that was like before, like, you know what I'm saying, Gucci and all them really got it going, because I feel like Gucci was one of my big influences, you feel me?
Fuck you, man, this Atlanta, man.
Yeah, like, Gucci was a big influence on my, especially like, growing up in East Atlanta, you feel me? Like, seeing home, like, that shit was like, you know what I'm saying, like, a big influence on this shit.
Gucci, man, fuck you, me, Lemonade,
yeah, him, OJ, all of them, bro.
With that being said, School of Tough, School like underground legend.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I'm saying? With that being said, do you think it's the underground scene is more potent than like what's up? Because you got your, Lil Baby, 21, Future.
Yeah.
Savage. Who else like you would consider? I ain't gonna say Huncho and who were you talking about? David Drill.
Yeah.
But they just like coming up from the underground, so you still get them that juice.
Yeah.
So you think it's right now that what we listening to that don't nobody know about, the radios they playing, is hotter than the artist right now that's dropping like major albums, or you think basically the artist that's
it's major.
They still holding their weight.
See, it's like they still be holding their weight because they anticipate. You know what I'm saying? Because they done came through the grind a lot of them. So it's like our Future just dropped some shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, that shit anticipated. You know what I'm saying? They was like, shit, nigga needed that shit. You feel me?
Listen, you break up Future. I'm about to go ahead and get this out of the way. Kendrick Lamar, man.
Yes, out there went crazy.
He won all the smoke.
all that. Yeah, Kendrick on all that.
We know Cole probably at the studio now, right? My boy has sent me a reel. Say, J. Cole riding the bike to the studio right now. Drake can get all of nigga business if he want to.
Yeah.
Like, is Drake like too far? And like, I ain't say La La Land, but like, nigga ain't fuck with me either way. Or you think Drake getting ready to come on and play a little bit?
I feel like Drake gonna play. I feel like Drake gotta play though. Just because him and J. Cole did that song, then they would kind of take a shot to it.
You think they would take a shot to Kendrick? Kendrick did?
Yeah, you feel me? Like, I kind of did too, because basically them niggas was saying, like, shit, nigga, we the top two, you feel me?
That nigga said, first person shooter, you about to bring three switches?
Yeah, Shadow went crazy on that.
That nigga said, motherfuck the big three. It's the big me is like, sounds like the Kendrick, Cole, and Drake, man. But, listen, we want to see music. This is what we've been missing, man. The top three niggas, we need to get hit. But, Big Sean dropped today.
Oh, he did?
At one point, Sean was in that conversation with them boys.
He was in that conversation.
I don't think he... Nigga, you heard that goddamn finesse two times? Sean dropped something.
Everybody dropped. Like, it was a lot of shit dropped.
Well, it ain't normal when everybody drop on each other like that.
Nah,
like, finesse got in there. Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
But, I guess, Future got down. So, you think it was a beef? You think Future was talking to Drake?
I don't know.
That the homie, right?
Yeah. That was the homie, bro. I don't know, bro. I think, it could be, that'd be the internet talking, you know what I'm saying, speculating a lot of shit and shit. Nigga don't really know.
What you be looking for your next project or the type of music you make, you know what I'm saying?
I feel like I make all around music, you know what I'm saying? I make real life music. I feel like my music be like real life shit. It be like, you know what I'm saying, shit you going through, shit I'm going through. Shit, somebody around me going through, you know what I'm saying, done experience, done that scene.
The real pause. So who inspired you to make music?
Gucci. T.I. one of my favorite.
When I do my top five, I would pick T.I. right now.
Yeah.
Because a lot of, I don't think my other folk from the city. Yeah. So, you gotta make sure you go to. If I had to pull one from the city, you would be too.
Yeah.
I pulled Gucci and Jesus.
Yeah.
And too.
Yeah. Child of crap, especially if I can. Full 50 Cent. Tell 50 Cent. Future. See, I fuck with like Downside, Outkast, Good Mob, you know what I'm saying? I thought it was like Down South shit.
Fucking Killer Mike got a Grammy.
Yeah, Killer Mike got like
three.
Yeah, Killer Mike went crazy.
So listen, is that saying that the young music is that water that they had to give it to like an old vet?
See, I feel like
you working on some new shit?
Nah, I got the new shit coming. I'm actually working on the EP. I don't know what name that's gonna be yet. I'm probably drop a single at probably the end of the month. I'm dropping a little single.
You gonna come back and do that brick flow for me?
Gas to come do the brick flow.
Gas to.
Yeah, we probably gonna drop that motherfucker on there.
Come back and do a premiere on that motherfucker.
Yeah, what we gonna do? We gonna drop that motherfucker on there. So different right media. Man. My next single for sure we drop.
That's fine. You know what I'm saying? We getting exclusives already, you did.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So different media, man.
Right.
It ain't a movie if it ain't a movie podcast. You ain't got no emotion to fuck.
Fuck
is
you thinking?
Goddamn, it's a lot of shit that been going on, a lot of questions. How tapped in, like, I don't know everybody how they phones and shit. How tapped in you with, we just going down on that meet me as academics and shit. You know what I'm saying?
I be saying that shit, but cause I don't really be watching TV like that, so I be watching YouTube. So I be seeing that shit pop up, like, nigga be got down. I feel like Meek Mill be too, he too emotional to appear. He too emotional, but he like, he care too much what people think about him. You know what I'm saying?
Nick don't learn me. Academics fucking wrong.
Nah, for real. Academics, man, listen. You heard what Shop said? He said, man, for 30 days or 30 nights.
You see when he went at the baby, but we heard shit. Like no music and stuff. That nigga said.
Because.
Nigga said, Pete called me. I'm like, hey, man.
Because he academic on them nigga like, bro. Every the day. Labels fuck with him. He's a big blog. He's a music blog.
Every day.
People follow Shop.
So you can record every day, but. Home, it's hard to every drop day. Every day.
You can't drop every day. And home is on every day. Every day. Every day he blogging. He blogging for hours, bro.
Yo, 2-3 tweets ain't fucking with 6 hours. Cool. I wake up like 4 in the morning. You know what I'm saying? Give me a little workout there before I go to work and shit. I'm listening to this nigga, cool. I get up like 4. Around about 8 o'clock, cool, that nigga still be talking. Mm-hmm. And it's still the same shit. Meek Mill.
From the day before.
Like, you know, whoever piss him off.
Yeah.
Other than that, I like the content and the news he give. But when he focus on the bullshit. But that come from like the I don't wanna say my end, I don't wanna piss nigga off. But that come from like civilians or like the folk that wasn't in that world that was fucked with in school.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They couldn't fuck with the street niggas. They couldn't come out there and shoot and run and fight.
Yeah.
But you come on that computer, they got your ass.
And you can't play with them on that.
That's their world. And that's come here.
That's
come here.
Different.
I don't think you understand. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
And that's
the thing. Don't go fucking playing with that boy on that computer, man.
You can't play with shit on the internet. Like, it's certain shit. Like, bro, get what? If you a street nigga, that internet shit don't apply to you. You ain't supposed to be in out of internet shit. Let that shit go.
Once you a civilian, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, unless you know what I'm saying? It's like, if you like feel like, oh, I'm civilian, cool. Then, alright, then, right.
Hey, girls, come on. Like, all, like.
Yeah, I'm fucking the South Carolina.
But almost all the girl team hard because they won't leave. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what's the girl name? I don't want to get her name wrong. I think it's Juju. Play for USC.
Oh, Angela Reese, right?
Yeah, she
played
for LSU.
LSU.
I
they won't you. Leave. Like, they make money in college. You know what I'm saying? So if
that's what they're doing, they're going to have
to force their ass out of there.
This the thing, though, bro. See, the WNBA so fucked up. They make more money with that NIL shit than they will when they
that's
make
money. That's why they won't leave. Why the fuck I'm going to let you come pay me?
That's why it's like, shit, as long as I can stay here and make this $3 million a year, I'm going to do that.
She got a Reebok deal now.
Exactly. Because she going to have a big following once she get to the WNBA.
You think Reebok going to start back buying this shit? I know I'm going to battle fucking Kamikaze and Shaq.
Yeah, because Shaq and NBA, Shaq and AI got
you going to battle Shaq's.
Yeah.
But them two pairs, you going to battle Shaq's, you going to battle AI's.
Yeah.
What other fucking people are you gonna buy?
They gonna have to come out.
You think they gonna bring their classic all white motherfuckers?
See,
back?
I feel like.
With the soft.
I feel like because.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
The Reebok, the all white.
The soldiery.
No, the other one, the all white with the little gray trim.
Oh.
The all day all white. These niggas used to rock them bitches. I don't give a fuck. Yeah, I might go get a pair. I got some aqua green motherfuckers like that. With the tan bottom. Bitch,
yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you think
I feel be, like cause Shaq and AI fucking with it.
So you think it'll be back when folk will be walking up down the street like.
Yeah. You see folk shit, you see, yeah. I feel like a lot of shit that used to be like, oh, we went folk with this shit. That
hold on, I'm gonna go back here. I ain't seen shit in a minute. Me and my son were watching one of your videos and I told him I was gonna ask you this shit. Where the fuck you get a bank from? I said, Pete, come here. I said, where the fuck this nigga in a bank for? He walking that motherfucker. Real nigga, he did. Nah, yeah, fact. But, shout out to Marquise James, my video.
Marquise and my brother Weston and Ricky Carey, they had them found their motherfucker. And that shit in the heart of the city, you feel? Nice little spot, nice little view, you feel?
That helped, that motivated me with like what I got going on now. Cause you remember when we was, back then, we were trying to shoot the little movies. And listen, when I go back and look, when I redid my page and shit, I went and looked at some of the old shit. And with more memories than probably what we posted.
Yeah.
We was here already.
Man, listen, bro.
That's crazy. Like, man, the blogs, the interviews. All that shit, bro.
Like, looking back on that shit, bro, what we were doing back in the day, bro, with that so different shit, bro. Like, we literally had a whole label. Like, artists, CEOs, music. We just couldn't get in the door, bro. You feel me? Like,
I take that hit a little bit. That's what I've been trying to learn. That even with sitting here talking to you, I've been trying to learn. I told my son Pete, he good with conversation. I told him, I said, cause that's almost like a gift.
Yeah, it is a gift.
I think that shit holding me a lot.
Yeah.
Cause nigga used to talk to me. You know what I'm saying? And it was sometimes about money, but sometimes to me it was like, fuck. You know what I'm saying?
But see, to what you saying, I feel like that was like how we were raised up, you feel me? And the environment we came up in. It was
street fucking
like
up.
It was the streets, you feel me? And it was like, because we came up in the streets and we were still in the streets, it was like we still looked at everybody sideways like they were trying to play us no matter what. You know? Even if they weren't trying to play us, you feel me?
Because I had even when we had conversations, when I had started talking to promoters, like my Texas and shit was all, bro, we need you there. He was like, boom, you come, you bring the whole movement. So it took my sister to kind of take the phone and be like, the fuck you gonna give me here? You know, like, you keep calling us, you keep giving me goddamn there. I'm spending money. You making me pay again this motherfucker. I got 10 niggas with me. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Where the bottle? Where the VIP at? You talking about motherfucker asking you where we at? Going to see us.
And
niggas start coming in. You know what I mean?
And that's why that shit was like, but that shit was like learning for all of us, you feel me, bro? Because, shit, nigga, this is your first time being the CEO of a whole label, bro. Bro, you got a whole label with. Bro, you had down there 10 artists, bro.
10 artists,
you feel me? Like, and you support everybody's shit like it's only one artist, like, you feel like me? Like, everybody you gave, everybody they own individual goddamn time. Like, bro, you come over here this day, you come over here this day. Matter of fact, you come over here this day early, and you come over here this day in the evening, and y'all gonna do some shit together in the middle of this.
I don't give a fuck if y'all over there, but what?
But and that how that shit was, bro. Like, that's why nigga respected that shit, bro. Like,
I'm sure this shit, man. I had one look at this shit the other day.
Bro, listen, bro. Nigga, you went and printed t-shirts, nigga.
I was like,
bro, that exactly, bro. Album covers, bro. All that shit, bro.
I said, man, what the fuck?
Bro, listen, bro. Bro, you had a real label, bro. Like, God, you went about
everything,
bro.
We need. I said, cause we need t-shirts. We went about a t-shirt press,
bro, listen,
heat press,
everything we needed, bro. Bro, listen, bro. Sticker. I seen a Soul Difference ENT sticker, bro.
Right.
I swear to God, with the green alien here,
made
with the mohawk on that motherfucker.
Right.
You feel me, bro? Like, bro, we did all that shit, bro. In house, bro, and we were posting them bitches everywhere, bro. Like, we was on some real Master P out the trunk shit.
They ain't that my eyes hurt staring at the screen looking at YouTube and talking to producers and niggas that were fucking with me trying to goddamn cook. Music had to be mixed. Videos had to be mixed. CDs had to be printed.
Fact.
Shirts had to be made. You know what I mean?
Fact. And that's why still to this day, like right now, bro, like shit, why the hell you. Bro, listen, bro, you hit me and said, bro, when I seen you were doing the podcast, before you ain't hit me, bro, I was already finna hit you like, oh boy, I want next on there. Like, fuck that. I should have been the first motherfucker on that motherfucker. He talking about, like, no, I want this. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, hey, yeah, bro. Like,
you probably seen that here, like, okay.
But listen, bro, as soon as I see it, I was like, oh, shout on that bullshit. Yeah, Let me go ahead and slide over there and see what the hell you got.
I done switched it up.
Yeah, yeah, bro, because it's like, man, what? Like, but that what you supposed to be doing. That what you supposed to be doing.
And I ain't even started goddamn, like, they don't even know yet. You know what I'm saying?
I swear to God, I was just gonna say that. Like,
I don't even know if that gonna be
default.
What I'm gonna do for content? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, listen, bro. I'm going ahead. Let the audience know, bro. You need to go ahead and do your theme song for them motherfuckers.
What you mean?
That need to be you, bro. Like, default need to know what's going on. Like,
it ain't moving. We take shots and we take movies.
Hey, you talking about?
Look, shout out to my son. That's P, the intro on the
For real?
Yeah.
Hey, you talking about shout out to my boy P, man. That boy, man, listen, boy, P done came a long way, P. Swear to God.
Nigga, I had a phone call. One day I was on the phone with one of my partners because that nigga was talking. He was like, oh, I remember. Come, I got that eye. I was like, damn. One thing a nigga told me, because if you don't leave got their past in the past, that shit gonna be your future. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna be no soft ass old nigga. I remember back in the day. Now, later with 18 cent. Y'all nigga riding you.
Yeah, nah, for real.
I like it. Cause, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get my ear for the younger, because I'm so into music.
Yeah.
Like, my ear probably stopping at like 20. But when it get down, like, what my daughters and shit listen to, they kind of, I'm still trying to figure that
out. Yeah, man, it get different down now.
But I guess probably like everybody, that little young nigga on anti, I had just seen,
Chuck got locked up today.
Yeah. Hey, man. Free that boy anti, man. Young nigga, man, trying to goddamn get up through that. They always. Why the fuck anti police lock a nigga up and say robbery? They got money. Who the fuck? They gonna rob, like, so I rob somebody. Yeah,
they just be trying to play a nigga.
But it's different with them.
See what it is? You know what I'm saying? Bro, you done lived that life. So you ain't worried about the fuck coming. You kicking in your door, you feel me? Like, you an OG in this shit. You talk about this shit. You know, you gotta respect this shit.
All the nigga really trying to do, cuz, for y'all see this, you know what I'm saying? Y'all out there working, you know what I'm saying? Cause I fucking had a whole record label, man. You know what I'm saying? Artists, bills. I used to got them. I fried, got them a whole pan of chicken. You know what I'm saying? We had eating like
self-made.
It won't just got them. You know what I'm saying?
This shit was self-made. It won't
like just I had a bunch of niggas back there in the room rapping, starving, thirsty, eating. Cause we ate like a family. We broke bread together like a family. But what I'm saying is, I ain't doing that no more. But I still got so different management, and I still love this shit. You know what I'm saying? So. If anybody out there is serious, you know what I'm saying? I still fuck around a little bit. Because folk don't do development. I think
bro, and that's more. Really what you have, bro. Bro, you know what? Damn, that's crazy. Niggas didn't even know that shit, bro. But that's really what you had, bro. Artist development.
And all y'all niggas came out like.
But everybody came from nowhere, bro.
Yeah, it was a mission.
Everybody came from nowhere, bro. It was like, oh shit, Red got a studio. Oh,
everybody
shit.
Was from nowhere, because you got motherfucking.
Everybody from everywhere.
Got there.
I was right there out of East Atlanta.
East Atlanta. You got motherfuckers South Side. You got motherfucking Jonesboro Road. You got motherfucking.
That shit was crazy, bro. Everybody was got there from everywhere.
East Side. And we
all this shit came together, bro. Yeah. To that day, bro. All this still, bro. Every time a nigga see a nigga, like, be like, bro.
You know why? I can't even remember no altercation.
Cause it wasn't there.
I'm talking about.
Wait, one night, it was so much respect, bro. Yeah. We were young and thugging, bro. Everybody was it, bro. Listen,
I'm talking about good. I mean, yeah,
man, what? Every time I came in this bitch, it was like, you know what I'm saying? Everybody had their own shit going on wherever they was from. But it was like, this was like the safe zone, bro. It was like, bro, when we came to your spot, to the studio, bro, it was like, whatever was going on, bro, out there, outside, them doors that got down, you feel me?
My kid used to run around between y'all, man.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Like, now, bro, like, bro, seeing, like, P and Cortez, bro, what, bro? They grown in hell, bro, you feel me? Like, bro, I remember when them niggas, young nigga running around that bit, you feel me?
Like, little y'all bit boy. Cook, like, y'all, they family, y'all, like, what they know.
Bro,
like,
yeah, fact, bro, like, them young nigga family, like, we grew up with them niggas, bro, that's why that shit. And your little girl, bro. Shout out to Millie.
Kenya.
Shout out to Kenya. Hey, you talking about
that life fat. That's why I know. Cause it was time, like, cause I had a big ass gap. Like, for real. Like, us from me from them.
I still got you, bro.
My kids still used to be like, what JB? What Chris?
Fat.
What Ben? These my kids. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, should I got them? Go find you, nigga. But y'all growing. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all would be. But one thing about niggas, I have family, niggas go through shit.
Life started, life and all
that. So I always told people, you know what I'm saying? I had to let them niggas grow, you know what I'm saying? Because once they grow, then we can got them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's how the world, bro.
You, that's how the world, when you boys turned into men.
If you
bro.
Make a motherfucker, if I would ever even try to keep y'all at little kid forever. Just never grow up. You know what I'm saying?
I wish.
but no, that's crazy. Cause y'all still would have grew up, but would have had like a kid. Like, what I'm saying, y'all nigga all big, got motion. I can sit down with y'all and we can make moves. You know what I'm saying? That even like with my kids. That's what I'm saying. I could have kept my kid like, y'all never grow up. But now I need my kid to be big. Like my boy that got them recording us with the camera. You know what I'm saying? I need my kid to be big to be able to have motion with them too. You know what I'm saying? So then the motion that I got with y'all, like you know what I'm saying, my partner Murray, Noon, you know what I'm saying, Jizzle, it's like round table shit, you know what I'm saying? Like.
Yeah. Nah, fat. And that shit, you know what I'm saying, bro? Man, bro. One thing I always say, but the shit done came a long way. And like, but I always respect you, really, bro, because. But like, you always like, you know what I'm saying? Nah, for real. You always like, bro, you believed in this shit. And you was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, bro, you put into this shit, you was like, bro, hell yeah, bro, I bet, come on, we finna do this shit. Like, bro, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we finna do this shit, you feel me?
Like, we were like, show. Like, it ain't like we just was.
Nah, hell nah, bro, we were doing shit, bro. And it was like, I feel like, bro, because you believed in all of us so much, bro. We got down, was like, we can't let the nigga down, bro. Like, we got to turn up, bro. You feel me? Like, bro. And the shit was hard, bro. It was like, you know what I'm saying? Shit was hard, bro. It was like, we just got down. Shit, motherfucker, winter, we can't go no more. You feel me? Like,
I just sit in the studio. I just sit in the studio where y'all nigga dip or be sleeping. Yeah. I sit in the studio. I be listening to shit. God damn, these niggas hard. I listen to songs. So I say, let me try some. I might catch him. I got a singing flow, right? But you know, I might say, shit, I wonder if I put a JB on a song with Cassie. Or what if I let Tito do a song with goddamn Ben? Because the melodies and tempo were so different.
Yeah.
Then. You couldn't tell me if I want on the song, we won't spray.
Yeah. And the shit was so crazy, bro, because it was like, everybody was like from a different part of town type shit, you feel me? So everybody had their own flow type shit.
You remember I used to say that shit? The reason I love this fucking label, ain't nobody rapping like
nobody. Nobody sounded like nobody, bro. Like, everybody had their own flow, like, everybody was from somewhere different, bro, so it was like, boy, that shit sound, and then it was like, bro, when that shit came together, bro, like, bro, all us on the song, bro.
Change the setting up a little bit, man, so y'all work with us, man, you know what I'm saying? Mark Chill, JB, he done brought the crew with him, you know what I'm saying? We gonna start off on left to right with introductions. Left right here, listen. They you see they rolling up, man, you know what I'm saying? They rolling up that left to right, you know what I'm saying?
Saying if Cam, you know, big SL, you know what I'm saying? Shit, you know, and just keeping it going in the EA, you know how that goes.
Nah, fat man, you know your boy, JB, Julio Band, you know what's up, any bit, man. So I'm saying, shout out to West End, you know, any bit. My brother's with me, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, some you?
Different shit, WMG,
for
you know
life.
What I'm saying? You know what's going on, so different for life.
Who we got next to you?
Brother,
you know what I'm saying? What's up,
y'all?
Smoke. Smoke it,
big smoke, you know.
That's
fingers around that bitch. You know what I'm saying?
That
real.
Instagram, man.
Y'all give y'all
Instagram and everything. You know what I'm saying? Let them know who y'all is.
Shit, y'all can follow me at sayless.cam. It's spelled S-A-Y. Less is spelled literally L-E-S dot cam.
You might see me bring your ass up on 700. I'll be outside. Catch me Willie in that kennel on the bike with no shirt on. That's me.
Exactly, for real, smoking, man. That's it, man. Keep the lady from me. It ain't that person, man. God's hurt, too, man.
Always.
G1F08, man. God's hurt.
Yeah, shout out to Come In, man. You know what I'm saying?
I like the environments.
Gotta have my brothers come pop out and shit.
It's dope, man. It's dope for the support, man. I so appreciate y'all coming.
Yeah, yeah.
We gonna go in. I was telling JB when we went. I wanted to talk to him about Wendy. You know what I'm saying? You think he is what he is? Like he gonna be him?
Yeah.
Or he like an early flower? They might.
That boy Wimby gonna be alright, bro. I think Wimby. You know what I'm saying? Wimby, man. Bro,
okay.
Wimby
okay.
Don't believe in him, bro. But I think, bro. Get away. Shout out to Rick, fresh in the league, bro. From OC, bro.
Yeah, Durant did the same fucking thing.
Yeah, but
Giannis did too.
Yeah, what though, bro?
Look at his bro.
He gonna be better than both of them.
It's crazy they give women so much praise, but don't say nothing to what that African name?
Not Subac, but
play for Phoenix.
Same thing.
I mean, like he the same thing, right?
Yeah, exactly. See, that's my point.
Ooh. Bobo just don't get the play. You give Bobo a team. Put him somewhere. Put him Washington up there with them boys. I bet he probably do some crazy numbers.
Well, we're gonna y'all gonna be honest.
Talk to me.
Who's more? We took my money, right?
Yeah.
You gonna buy a shirt with Bobo black ass on now? You gonna buy a Bobo
right. That's
all politics.
I mean, yeah, that's you too.
Yeah, what though?
If Bobo was balling, though, you'll buy a shirt with a face.
No, he been balling. He been watching.
He been balling with the second team.
But what I'm saying is, put Bobo
music. Women buy picture shirts.
Put Bobo on Washington and start him.
Yeah.
I bet he have a different.
He'll be going crazy.
Yeah.
He'll be going crazy. He need to get somewhere where he ain't behind Kevin Durant.
So everybody in the world saying the same thing. Is everybody saying the same thing? Give him another ring, or we Celtics.
Nah. Or you think
somebody gonna sneak in and sneak a ring, Lakers?
I don't know. I'll
be honest.
It's over, man.
I start watching sports because sometimes I lose money. So I ain't gonna lie, I start watching it. I got to the
Lord
point.
Bro, I'm like,
I would have bet this is over. I'm a championship though. Every sport, no matter if it's football, basketball, I bet on hockey. I bet on anything. Listen, catch me at championship. I'ma just go with my gut. I'ma bet with you. But watching out through the season.
It is what it is.
Lakers going to the championship,
man. I'm with you.
Oh, yeah.
That's some different shit, man.
Oh, y'all nigga reaching.
Don't do that, man.
Oh, y'all nigga reaching.
We were reaching last year, too.
Yeah, exactly. We were reaching last year, too.
You know what hurt me? And when I told my sons this shit, I don't think they see how deep I was looking in the basketball. I don't think Lakers should ever, like, Scooter was like, he the shit, cuz.
Him and Dwight Howard.
Both.
Dwight
and I don't think they understand what we saying. Then when we say the shit,
oh, how?
Listen,
bro.
Listen.
When Dwight Howard played against Jokic,
you talking about raping niggas? Dwight Howard?
He was raping Jokic.
He was raping. He was raping. He was raping him more than Anthony Davis is.
Exactly.
Change the players.
All the players. You say Dwight Howard?
Cause see, this is what he's saying is same thing as Scooter. These are installed or like, but get what? Them folks getting in. I hated that Lakers got rid of Scooter. He can help D'Angelo Russell so much, like as a backup
point guard. They locked D'Angelo Russell.
Get him up there, give me feel.
Or Draymond Green, the nigga that do the little shit. The nigga that do the little shit that you need, bro, to win the championship.
Scottie Pippen.
Scottie Pippen.
Lakers supposed to never let. He supposed to be on the bench till he retired, man. So that boy get it in.
So look, I got a question for y'all, right?
What we going?
Okay, boom. Here we go. End of the world. You got to pick. A 5-star team, from old to young, you can go back past Jordan.
But
What's your top five?
Go. LeBron.
Okay.
Motherfucking Jordan.
Woo. Okay.
That's on with a shoe guard, small forward.
Yup.
Okay. Steph at point. Right.
I think we got the same line.
So the power forward. I'm putting Shaq at center.
Yes.
Automatic. I thought y'all said
AD. And I'm putting AD at power forward. I'm putting AD at power forward. I'm going Shaq, AD, Steph, LeBron, Jordan.
Mm.
I don't give a fuck who you bringing in, Tim.
I'm gonna put Kyrie at one, and I'm gonna put AI at my one. So who you getting rid of? Curry gotta go. I'm gonna replace Curry with Kyrie, and then whoever your two was, I'm gonna go with AI. Curry gonna go, man. I just gave you the best team in the world. Curry can go. I just gave you the best team in the world. Let's, who you gonna get? Charles Barkley, Kevin Durant.
Nah,
Devin Booker.
I just gave you the best team. I take Reggie Miller at my six.
Fuck
Reggie. You know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna mark LeBron, LeBron James gonna run the point though. Listen, I ain't even stuck with LeBron. LeBron gonna be my point. Patrick to the middle. LeBron gonna be my coach. MJ gonna be my shooting guard. Shaq gonna be my third. Give me them five. Then I'm gonna put Shaq at my son. I still think my five still together. Shaq, I'm gonna put Shaq at my son. Kobe, I'm gonna put Shaq at my son. Kobe, I don't think I'll switch out the Iverson. I'm gonna tell you why. AD at the four for a reason.
I put Shaq at my five. I put Hakeem Olajuwon at my four.
I put Hakeem Olajuwon.
Then I went Steph.
Now AD can shoot. Then I went Steph, LeBron, and Kobe. We know he can. I got Shaq at my five. AD at my four.
I don't care. That's why I said, I don't care who you pick. When AD been at four, is a problem. Who you gonna pick right there? Olajuwon?
Yeah.
You still got Shaq.
I put Olajuwon. But I got Shaq at my five.
Put Yana there.
At four,
I got Shaq at my five.
AD will kill Yana.
Nah, I don't know.
No, sir. Now that center, we talking about at the four position.
No, AD, Draymond Green.
At four? Against who?
Okay.
He gonna play defense, but I'm gonna put up 100 points. And Draymond gonna give me eight.
I'm gonna get the point. I got Kobe, MJ, LeBron, Shaq, the AI.
So why you talking about Draymond Green?
You start talking about the defense. You start talking about defense because I'm going with Pat Beverly, man. You know what I'm saying? I want Pat Beverly like my number seven.
I want Pat Beverly at six. Pat Beverly at seven.
Reggie Miller, man.
Man, I'm telling you. Or you can give me that boy right here.
My number six. I can't even say his name. I want Penny too. See, my second five would be
healthy Penny.
But then you go, Kevin Durant.
If you go healthy, then you go Penny. You go on Grant Hill.
Yeah.
You go on Byron Scott. You go on, man, there's a couple of niggas, man. Them niggas dope as fuck.
I take Dominique Wolf too.
If you go hurt, Jay Will, shit change. Vern Davis, man, Vern Davis was crazy. That was if you go hurt, then you change the conversation. Cause
Vern Davis was retarded,
but he was crazy though. But what y'all boys have going on, man? Y'all got them came show up. You know what I'm saying? We get ready to start making this shit more official, man. Gonna be start be a weekly thing, man. We building up content, man.
We gonna be here weekly, so y'all get used to seeing these faces. We gonna be here. We gonna be here. We getting everything together, everything in the process.
We talking about everybody. Pay attention and watch what's going on, because we're going to be here. I got a question, right? So y'all think they're going to come home? Yeah, he coming home. From what I've been seeing, how the fuck you going to sit here and tell me he coming home? It'll take three years to try this case. Man, stop playing with me. They're going to say they got 400 witnesses and they only on 40. Stop playing, man.
That's crazy.
Come on, 400 people snitching.
But listen, Jay, 400 people snitching.
You know what I'm saying? Goosey took 10. I say Thug might have to take a 10. You know what I'm saying?
He gonna do about 4 years.
They shake, yeah, shake that shit off. You know what I'm saying?
Sit and wait. Yeah, wait. By the time they do, they gonna throw it out. Yeah, they gonna do the rest of the
match. Nah, they gonna give him a 10. And
but see, I seen some shit today that said. Well, I actually seen on YouTube. I wish I could. Or I might pull it up. But I seen some shit today. The fucking that nigga lawyer stood up and asked the jury, what is it, recused himself.
Yeah, to move.
He was like, man, I think you biased against my goddamn client. But that's for records. So when they had to do an appeal or something, he asked his ass. He said, hey, let me get this on record. Let me say this so they can hear it and record it.
You covered his ass.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I asked you, he asked him more than once.
His chin's not up, that was smart.
Yeah.
That was smart.
Yeah. That was what you paid for.
He said, do we think Miller coming
on?
Miller just shook them for what? I watched that whole trial.
I'm
paying for that shit,
girl. The shit that got Miller fucked up is.
You know what I said?
Yeah, Miller come home.
Uncle Spears theory. You know why
he come home.
You
did it, girl.
You know why he come home. Everybody know he did it, but you know why that guy come home.
I mean, we ain't gonna say he did it.
I don't think he did it. I was in Atlanta, Georgia.
Allegedly.
Me personally, I paid for the shit to watch. I'm talking about work and everything, listening to that shit. That shit was weird, man. You know what I'm saying? And he shook that motherfucker up. They did a mistrial because they knew he was getting ready to shake it. You know what I'm saying?
He didn't do a Dion.
He did.
I ain't even watching.
The evidence so... I don't know if it makes sense when I say off on point. You know what I'm saying? But from what I was saying, it was like...
So yeah,
you can say he did it, I can say he didn't. That's how the evidence was. It wasn't like... Yeah. Nobody right. You know what I'm saying? That's how crazy it was. Yeah.
It ain't like you ain't gonna be like, oh yeah, it's for sure this sound.
Yeah, that one was right. That OJ shit. Yeah. OJ Walk. You know what I'm saying? Free Lucha, man. Yeah. Lucha be home back 2-3 months, man. You know what I'm saying? Shots out to Soul Hill boys, man. You know what I'm saying? Shots out that boy
too. Yeah.
Rollo been going crazy.
Rollo home, man. Shouts out to Rollo, man. You know what I'm saying? Future just dropped.
It's on the way, bro.
Motherfucking Kendrick Lamar, man. Again, Kendrick Lamar eating niggas' heads. What y'all think about that Kendrick Lamar version?
I don't know, but I'm listening to that.
You ain't heard it. You heard that Kendrick Lamar version?
I ain't heard it, but I'm disappointed.
You can't say you ain't heard it.
I'm just
disappointed. You ain't heard it.
I'm going to play it.
Future
album.
Yeah, that
make no sense.
You
must
have heard the song of the album.
What my fault?
They played
this
shit.
That part of the album.
I was listening to it. He had me with the first song, the second song.
You like Crying Future?
He ain't on that one no more. Bro, listen, bro. That man be saying some shit.
They been honeycomb brazen hard.
Yeah.
He was so mad Shawty went back. He deserved what he was finna get coming to. But he always tell me, finesse dropped the goddamn song today.
Bro, one thing I don't like, bro. I don't like how finesse be goddamn.
Bro,
you wasn't dissing Shawty and talking all that shit.
Bipolar, two bottles. Hey, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem. shit, no 21 coming. Yeah, yeah, get up with me, fuck sneak this. First person shooter, I hope they came with three switches. I crash out like fuck rap, this Melly Mel if I had to. Got two teams with me, I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos. It's up, lost too many soldiers not to play it safe. If he walk around with that stick, it ain't Andre DK. Think I won't drop the location, I still got PTSD. Motherfuck the big three, nigga, it's just big me, nigga.
Tell me what y'all think about that shit, man. Talk to me, man. Do I need to play that
fuck bitch again? Fuck three niggas just beat me.
You want me to play that motherfucker again, man?
I think they woke him up.
You
want to
play that motherfucker again?
They'll woke
that man up.
I think they woke him up.
But see, this thing about Kendrick Lamar, right? Kendrick Lamar wait 5 years to come out.
That shit right
and
there?
And then when he come out, he drop some hard, like, he pop out on shit like that, right?
I think we got smoke.
Yeah. But see, what he got to do, bro, he got to stay consistent. Like, alright, you just drop that shit and I drop an album.
Yeah.
You feel me? Drop an album and pop that shit on that motherfucker.
Don't
drop an album.
Drake gonna diss him first, then J. Cole.
Now, Cole in the studio right now.
Man,
Drake gonna slow diss him.
But see, J. Cole,
Drake coming back in the morning.
J. Cole
might be on the same beat.
Yeah. J. Cole gonna hit him up.
Drake shit gonna be slow on the album. He gonna sell 200 million on, and he gonna say some shit to that nigga. They gonna back down like, nigga, you.
If both of them niggas smart, bro, and them niggas wanna goddamn turn up for real. Both of them, they gonna
but listen, you said on that first person shooter, you think goddamn they were taking little shots at him. Cause he said goddamn y'all taking, he said y'all nigga clicking up taking shots.
Yeah.
So he must feel like on
Kendrick
that song.
That?
Yeah. Yeah. So and he must feel like on that first person shooter they were taking shots at him.
Yeah, they were.
He had to.
It was. You heard what J. Cole said. He said, me and Drake is like Spider-Man meme. The Spider-Man meme, me pointing at me. And pointing at me, and pointing at me.
But Spider-Man was like 8 9.
But get what? It's just me and you. And we're the only ones pointing at each other. It ain't nobody else.
But you know what else? Hey,
Drake,
you
got them folks in the head. Like,
he pull up on
that
he
won when Kendrick Lamar got a crazy fan base,
I'm going to tell you something else, Five. Because at one point, it was 4. You remember they had that Big Sean in that mix?
Big Sean
dropped
that too.
And this shit hard. Like, when I listen to it, that nigga getting off, bro. Yeah, he can really rap.
But see, Big Sean got down, he done got.
I think the way Kanye shitted on him hurt. Kanye shit on him bad, bro. Kanye shit on him bad, because I think that hurt him. Because one thing about you can't take that flow from Big Sean.
Yeah, nah, you can't take that flow from him. But the thing is, he be trying to do that Kendrick Lamar shit.
Kanye hard, man.
Musically, like Kanye's an instrument, like a piano or a guitar to me.
No, yes.
That's how I look at Kanye.
His personality, like what he be doing. Hey, hey,
shoot my shot like.
Auntie was in it, hey, mama had AAA. I wasn't scared to crash anyone anyway. I ride a shoddy while bro had a shoddy, like we in the getaway. I gotta penetrate, I gotta generate. I got like 20 some years to my hood, I gotta go live away. I'm out of town, but I'm not on the getaway. It's been a giveaway. Fuck you mean, I'm the generous king for real. I fuck up the street, then I light up the street, got a screaming like Billie Jean for real. I'm from the M, I got M's in the bank and M's in all my streams for real. Feeling like Phil, they be living like Carlton if I leave him in the wheel. Shoot my shot like, hey, hit the red dot like, hey.
Come on, man. Talk to me, man. These niggas rapping again.
Yeah.
We got music in the biz.
These niggas back rapping.
You want me to hear something that hard? No bullshit. That's finesse. I'm taking a look. But that Big Sean, but lyrically, I think Big Sean want to play.
Big Sean do want to play.
Man, that man think we're talking so hard.
What? Finesse
living my dream.
Man, what? Finesse living every nigga dream right now.
So y'all fucking that finesse movement?
No, man, listen. I'm going to be under with you.
I'm trying to do what you
want. I was fucking with Finesse back when he came out that bit, he was still in the streets. Finesse. Like, his music wasn't talking about nothing.
I'm real, bro. The rapper talking about nothing.
But we smoking so much of that motherfucker that finally tell him.
Smoking on the hoodie, man.
Ain't nothing burning. got the beeping stopped, man. Before we had them motherfuckers so smoked up. They done smoked up the studio, man, and fucking four alarms going off and shit.
It's only right.
We was smoking before we turned the cameras back.
Again, man, it ain't a movement if it ain't moving podcast, man. Y'all can get ready to start seeing these boys every week, man. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck!
He ain't got no motion to fuck. We finna make that work. We got a movie coming. We got a movie coming with Young D. What's that young lady's name? That you did the podcast with? She don't mind me saying you only kid at all. You only kid at all. Kid, we had to find another actress, you know what I'm saying? But we got a movie coming, you know what I'm saying? Like college, you know what I'm saying? And more like a series. That's what we're really shooting outside of podcast. Y'all gonna see a lot of series. We ain't doing like a lot of movies. It's gonna be more series type, you know what I'm saying? Different actors and different ideas. Y'all just stay tuned in, you know what I'm saying? Y'all sure. Wanna give them y'all name and y'all idea again, let them know who, you know what I'm saying?
Man, this is the biggest sale, man. Got this.
You know, your boy, Julio Van, one. J-U-L-I-O, Smokey A-N-D-Z. Man.
Smokey.
We in that bit, man. On all platforms, Apple Music, Spotify, YouTube, Instagram, TikTok.
You even play your song?
Yeah.
You know, listen, I wasn't going to say nothing, because we had talked about it on the last podcast, but I think everybody going to talk about this shit, you know?
And I wonder me if I ain't go out one lit.
Yeah, you talking about
it. I'm but that shit ain't happening until like June 20th, so we probably end up talking about it now again and again. Man. What y'all that Mike Tyson and Jake Paul, man.
Hey, man, my money on Tyson. Anybody want to bet, hit my line, bro.
Yeah.
I'm putting my money on. Hey, but listen, I'm slicky fucker, too, because I go bet on Jake Paul just to see what he
do. You say Jake Paul?
No, yeah. My money on Tyson.
But the crazy thing about Tyson,
you crazy. Mike finna lose my shit. He finna beat the shit out of Tyson. Mike, what's his name? My Mike gonna beat Tyson.
Listen,
no. So Mike gonna beat Tyson? Yeah. No, what? Tripping.
But listen, bro.
Y'all seen that video him punching that man?
Hey, y'all seen the rules of the fight, though?
No.
What the rules is?
See, the rules of the fight is...
He'll bite your ass.
Nah, fuck that. Jake Paul could tag in and out with his brother.
Nah, that's
new line.
Man, how about Ryan?
Jake, he's lying like a motherfucker, man.
Go look at the rules of the fight.
So they can tag in and out.
They can tag in and out with his brother, and Mike Tyson got to take a drug test, and they don't.
They gonna have to tag in and out.
They don't got to take no drug test. Mike Tyson got to take a drug test.
Some of them is full of crime and cocaine.
Do what I'm man, saying, though. It's
crime game.
For that PED shit.
It's crime game. Listen, what? I can hear him now. Mike, how did you do it?
Man, listen.
So listen, man, again, man.
What
did
they wrestle?
So listen, how could we like do the podcast? You know what I'm saying? Watch the fight or watch whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like we working on it, y'all. We building. You know what I'm saying? We working on it. We just getting it together, but we trying to bring what we can come to it. I'm saying. Fight night, you know what I'm saying? We got to project and shit. We just got to figure out what we can.
So what we got to do, we got to live screen that shit and give a reaction to that shit.
But what y'all feel like?
So that'll be like a reaction video. It'll be like a live reaction video.
So we put it on later or we'll talk about it, you know what I'm saying? But we getting content together for y'all, man. Like, subscribe.
We'll do it right then.
Because these motherfuckers, I ain't even know they go live too. They don't. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
For real?
Yeah.
That was real shit.
Yeah, I ain't know that either. Like, subscribe.
For you
know
sure.
We're going to be bringing y'all all kind of content. Go ahead and play the song. We're going to give y'all some. I kept you real with these niggas.
I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. Lord, today ain't deserved. I was in the field with these niggas. You was just sitting on the curb. I was trying to flip to a brick. You was trying to flip you a bitch. Now I turn out on the shit. Now I turn out to a bitch. I'm in the trenches getting rich. I'm having all the flavors. No handouts, no favors. These goosies not tables. This big man ain't rented. It's limousine tinted. If I said it, I meant it. Them young get they spin it. Bigfoot, I be stiff. Mm-hmm. Bigfoot, I be stiff. Mm-hmm. Oh, sure they sick. No damn, they glove a lethal weapon. That drink on that hip.
Hey, man. And shout out to my new podcast member, man. Already.
Show the girl to get the jump and that bitch will be stiff. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches. I kept it too real with these niggas. I kept it too real with these bitches.
They gonna be the intro. That shit hard.
I fuck with this shit.
They made it the intro.
Yeah,
look, man,
yeah,
the new podcast members, man, I knew what I'm saying. She was gonna be a part of Wave Fest, and we probably thought, man, we finna get some.
Man, that God worked,
man. Yeah, that God worked.
Man. Traffic, man.
I appreciate, you know what I'm saying, all the support, man. You know what I'm saying, we gonna grind this shit up for y'all, man. Yeah,
nah, for sure. Yeah, man, you already know what the fuck going on, man. WMG, so different shit, man. You know what the fuck going on. We in the building, man.
Yeah, man, it's rich and nothing, man.
For shit, show.
Yeah. God for man.
It ain't a movement if it ain't moving.
It ain't a movement if it ain't moving.
He ain't got no motion, though.